Hello, and welcome to Falcon TV. Today is Monday, May 11th, 2020. I'm Mr. Lockwood, along with the rest of the FTV crew. Today, our stories look at...
the good. The bad. The ugly.
That's right. The good, the bad, and, unfortunately, the ugly. So first we look at the good and promising news. The U.S. drug maker Pfizer and German partner BioNTech are set to begin a U.S. coronavirus vaccine trial. They said if the vaccine proves to be safe and effective in trials, it could potentially be ready for wide use distribution by the end of the year, shaving several years off the typical vaccine development timeline. The vaccine, which uses messenger RNA technology, has the potential to be among the first vaccines against the virus that has infected more than 1 million people in the United States and killed over 70,000 people. There are currently no approved treatments or vaccines for the new coronavirus, though some drugs are being used on patients under an emergency use authorization. Pfizer said last week it hopes to receive emergency authorization from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration as early as October and could distribute up to 20 million doses by the end of 2020 with an eye toward producing hundreds of millions of doses next year. Pfizer said it expects to make safety data on the vaccine available by late May and plans to expand the trial to sites across the United States in early July and may ultimately enroll more than 8,000 participants. If successful, the U.S. clinical trial would be one of the fastest ever progressions of a vaccine from early stage studies to regulatory approval, compressing a development process that often takes as much as a decade to just over 9 months. Both companies will jointly commercialize the vaccine if approved. With information about things getting worse before they get better, and the virus potentially being around for the next 2 years, the pharmaceutical giant is positive and optimistic, and here's hoping this trial will be effective against COVID-19. Now we turn our look to part two. When the virus first began, the thought was it started in Washington State. Well, something new is brewing in Washington State that was just seen that's not supposed to be there. And with that story, we go to Jada Mallory.
The world's largest hornet, a 2-inch killer dubbed the murder hornet with an appetite for honeybees, has been found in the United States in Washington State, where entomologists are making plans to wipe it out. In his decades of beekeeping, one beekeeper has never seen anything like it, spotting from the window a mess of bees' carcasses on the ground, and looking closer, seeing a pile of dead members of the colony in front of a hive and more carnage inside. Thousands and thousands of bees with their heads torn from their bodies and no sign of a culprit. Only later did they come to suspect that the killer was some researchers called the murder hornet. With queens that can grow to 2 inches long, Asian giant hornets can use mandibles shaped like spikes, sharp fins, to wipe out a honeybee hive in a matter of hours, decapitating the bees and flying away with the thoraxes to feed their young. For larger targets, the hornet's potent venom and stinger, long enough to puncture a beekeeping suit, make for an excruciating combination that victims have likened to hot metal driving into their skin. In Japan, the hornets kill up to 50 people a year. Now, for the first time, they have arrived in the United States. Their faces help with their name as they appear to look angry. They have a wingspan of 3 inches and a stinger a quarter of an inch long. Let's hope the Asian hornet doesn't become a permanent resident. This is Jada Mallory for Falcon TV News.
Thank you. And you're right. The only big hornets in America should be in Charlotte, North Carolina. So that critter has got to go. And now we look to the unfortunate on human behavior. Many people have done amazing things during this time, helping out others, being supportive. But sadly, there are some who take opposite actions. For this tragic story, we head to Rachel Stuber with more.
Michigan has been a place where armed protesters have been telling the governor to drop the stay-at-home order and just reopen businesses. But near Flint, Michigan, it went very wrong. Decisions like staying home when we can, wearing a mask when we go to the store, and staying a safe distance from those around us should not be political arguments. They are actions that are about safety and don't necessitate acts of defiance. However, for one man, that is exactly what happened. Calvin James Munoran, 43, and security guard at a Family Dollar north of downtown Flint, Michigan, was shot and killed after telling a woman her daughter needed a mask while staying inside the store. The woman and her daughter went to the Family Dollar, and security footage shows Mulleran and the mother got into a verbal altercation after he told the woman her daughter needed a face mask in order to enter the store. The woman yelled and spit at Mulleran, who asked her to leave the store and instructed a cashier not to serve her. 2 hours later, the son and husband came back and killed Mulleran. He was a father of nine, and a GoFundMe has been set up in his name. It can be hard to follow rules we don't like, but they are there to help with situations and for the good of everyone. The prosecutor said, as humans, we simply cannot devolve into the us versus them mentality. All of us need to look out for the well-being of others where we can, and that we really need to make a commitment as a community and do the things necessary to allow us to stay healthy. This has been Rachel for Falcon TV News.
Regrettable news unfortunately happens, perhaps too often, but people are working in conditions they are not accustomed to. And the importance of staying safe and dealing with the issues in these times as calmly and as peacefully and as respectfully as we can is key. So for me and everyone here at Falcon TV, be well and be well informed.